Yeah, Steve, you got on the phone. You got on a little bit later after Seamus. Seamus opened a second office, right, Steve?
Sure, I do.
During the time that you've been with me, you know that, right? And Seamus just said that that office is seeing 120 visits a week now.
Wow.
That's on 3 days a week, Steve. Now, why did I put that in your face?
I'm slacking.
Right. That's exactly why. Because who's there when you're self-employed, and I say this all the time, when you're self-employed, who's there to hold you accountable?
No one.
Nobody. And I said, well, that's one of the most difficult things about being self-employed. You can fuck off. You can go slow. You cannot put any pressure on yourself to increase your skill level at all. It's amazing how low of a standard you can allow for yourself. And that's a big issue when you're self-employed is the how easy it is to have lack of discipline. Well, lack of discipline's okay if you're just making money for yourself, right? If you're just making money for yourself and you're going to work. But how well is that working for you to leverage your time or money? How well is that working?
No, it's not.
You can have any leverage of time through any sources?
Just a rental property, but that's it.
Well, I said leverage of time.
Well, I mean, it's in.
So, you just have your employees, right? Okay, so you're leveraging some time, but outside of that, you're stuck, aren't you? You think you might want to pay attention to this and actually plan on getting an associate doctor?
Yes, sir. I agree.
Okay, well, that's not going to happen by you not increasing your skill level and not listening to, recording yourself. In other words, placing higher demands on yourself. It's not going to happen.
You're right.
And then if you don't have that, and again, Steve, how old are you, Steve?
60.
Yeah, I mean, Mark just says 60. Seamus is, us older guys, man, we can't fuck around. We don't have 30, 40 years of fucking around. We've got to go straight to leverage of time. That's our ticket. That's our ticket. That's our ticket to freedom. It's a sad story. One of my friends, he's 75 years old, chiropractor. He has to go to work every day. He has to. It's a sad story. 75 years old, and he has to go to work to maintain his lifestyle. He has no leverage of time, and he has no passive income. What's the only equity that he has in his life?
His house.
His house, and fortunately for him, he bought his office 40 years ago. And that's it. He doesn't have anything else. That's it. So the reason I'm pointing that out is that's what this is about. This is why you record yourself. This is why you want to hold yourself to a higher standard. This is why you want to pay attention to your statistics. So you can get this shit over with, and so you can hire that associate doctor and keep going and start becoming a manager instead of the widget person, with a mentality of just staying in your office, tit for tat, tit for tat, tit for tat. So, yeah, Seamus opened the second office, seeing 120 a week. So he's leveraged his time, leveraged his money, and then he's looking for a second associate doctor in his office. Seamus, can you see how much more secure you are with your Seamus, how old are you?
I just turned 56.
Okay, can you see how much more secure you and your brother are in your futures with these systems and the associate doctors in real estate?
Yes.
I mean, what chance in hell did you have 2 years ago?
Just widget away for the rest of my life.
How was that looking?
Not good.
I mean, that is not the way to go, you know, to live, you know, the last third of your life. So, I mean, look how much more opportunity you're having now, and how much more freedom, and even just seeing, you know, as this thing, you go, okay, I'm getting in control of this thing, to where I'm putting people in place that are productive, that are making money, and I'm like, okay, I can see how we can just have a great life in the last third of our life. I mean, how much more security is this created in your life?
Tons. I mean, if you'd see the future is going to be very secure.
Yeah. From a position of strength, not weakness. Weakness is not having good skill levels, not being able to leverage, not being able to train. In other words, now you're stuck in your office. So, you know, I'm just saying, I'm just amazed, you know, that how some people just don't take advantage or as fast as advantage of these things that, you know, we teach. Because I'm like, man, this is, I practiced only 7 years. 7 years. I had all my associates in place in 7 years. And then just manage it. If you want to practice part-time, fine. And then, if you got your systems, you know how to train it. But damn, if you're not even recording yourself, and you're not even paying attention to yourself, and you're not even paying attention to the systems, because you're not paying attention to the systems if you're not recording yourself. It's the end of the road. I mean, I would try to have an associate in there. Same with you, Mark. I'd try to have an associate. I would plan on just getting this thing straightened out. Make sure you got your retention down real well, and your stats reflect that. And to be honest with you, I'd have an associate in there by the end of this year. That's what I'd plan for. Just, you know, start planning on it. And by the way, Seamus, how much has bringing in the associate helped to increase your skill level and your brother's skill level?
It's immense. I mean, me and Sean were talking about it last night. It's just incredible. It just makes you more accountable, more focused, more, you know, in tune with what's going on with everything. I mean, it's just incredible. I think you got a great program. That's all I can say. But, you know.
Do you remember me saying early on, Seamus, I said the number one reason you should bring on an associate is not the first reason is not for the passive income. The first reason is for his accountability, and it will increase your productivity.
Yep.
That's the number one reason to bring on the associate. See, Steve, you think you would be doing what you're doing right now with the lack of accountability if you had an associate doctor?
Not at all.
This is why I keep saying this. You need to get an associate doctor, Steve, because it will help you with your accountability.
I see that big time. I do. You're right, 100%.
So same with you, Mark. I mean, that's part of the reason you need to get that. That's the number one reason is accountability. You won't drag around. You'll pay attention to these systems, and you'll get them in place. And I've always said it's a hell of a lot more fun when you have an associate doctor. I mean, have you noticed that, Seamus, how much more fun it is being in practice?
Yeah, it's pretty fun. Yeah, we're having a good time. Everyone's, you know, happy, and everyone's jamming. So I have no complaints, really.
Well, fun meaning you're interacting with another chiropractor. Of course, your brother's a chiropractor, so it's a little different. But guys that like the other guys on here that are in their office by themselves, I would say it's a lot more fun when you have another chiropractor in there that you can relate to chiropractically, because you can't relate to your employees. They're typically high school educated people. They're not chiropractors. And it's a lot more fun when you have another chiropractor to relate to, and not just the systems, but even clinically. Isn't it clinically nicer just to have another chiropractor around?
Yeah, you know, you get a little different opinion, different little look at things. You know, musculoskeletal problems.
Yeah. I just cannot recommend it enough. It does everything to increase your accountability, your productivity, your the enthusiasm in the office, the focus. You'll be way more focused. You'll be way more focused because you guys don't have to be focused when you're in an office by yourself. You can just go in there and meander and get through the day so you can get on Facebook or whatever it is you do. And you can't do that when you have an associate doctor. I mean, and that increased accountability increases productivity, and that's what creates self-worth. Self-worth is from productivity, not trying to get by with the lowest parameter. That doesn't create self-worth and value. I mean, I always feel the best when I'm the most productive. You know, when I'm helping the most people and having the greatest impact. That's when my value systems. So anyway, enough of that lecture, but if it was up to me, I would just, Mark and you guys, I would just, say, in 90 days, you've got 90 days to be a black belt in patient retention. And at the end of 90 days, we're hiring an associate doctor. If I could impose those rules, obviously I can't impose anything on you guys, but that's what I would do for all these things: productivity, value, leverage of time, freedom, all these things. You just got to get used to interviewing and training, because it's not going to be one. Steve, you're not going to start and stop with one associate doc. Then you want to go to the second one. Then you want to go to the third one. Then you want to regularly be able to interview and train associate doctors. Why? Because it creates security. That's what it does.
I agree.
So I'm not even talking one. I mean, I'm going from the mentality. You gotta have a machine. You gotta have your systems in place in that office, well trained. So it's a machine. It's like McDonald's University. That's what you gotta do. And then replicate it. And then regularly replicate it. And as they come through, go to the second one. Go to the third one. Sometimes they may not work out. Sometimes they'll work out great. And, of course, a lot of that will have to do with your increased skill level. The more you know how to pick people, the more better you are at training people. You know, just like with employees, when you start learning how to pick and train employees, it's amazing how you kind of get better employees. It's kind of interesting how that works.
Yeah, okay, like the book E-Myth.
So, that's just the mentality. Get the systems in place. Get that associate doctor. It helps increase all these factors. And then go for the second one. I mean, we just want that guy to get up over 80 visits a week. How easy is it with these systems, Steve, to get an associate doctor over 80 visits a week?
Very quickly.
Can you see how you would have had to pick a real loser to not get over 80 visits a week?
Yes, sir.
Well, what does 80 visits a week do, Steve? When you have an associate doctor seeing only 80 visits a week, what the hell does that mean?
Freedom.
Well, specifically what it means is a six-figure passive income. That's $100,000 plus a year. And how much money do I always say do you have to make on your own to have a passive income of $100,000 a year? $8 million. $8 million. 50% in overhead, $4 million. 50% in taxes, $2 million. 5% interest rate on $2 million. You don't even get a 5% interest rate in today's economy. How quickly can we take an associate doctor and get him 80 visits a week? 90 days. 90 days. How long is it going to take you to make $8 million?
A lifetime.
You're not going to.
I know.
You're not going to. There's not another way out. There's not a good another way out. There's a way out, but it's not good. I mean, you don't want to go out in the bottom. You want to go out on top. And then what's in the middle is not very appealing. Stuck in your office, no passive income, no freedom, and you're 60, 65 years old, 70 years old. That's not a good proposition.
No, sir.
So, you know, you got all the support, you got all the information, we got all the webinars, we got all the seminars, we got all the workshops. I mean, we got everything you need. Everything. If you're just willing to put a little more focus on yourself and discipline. And that's why I say, just get this over with. Mark, get this patient retention down. And I mean, just get this thing down from when you started to 90 days. You know, stop beating around the bush. And in 4 months, Mark, 4 months, let's start looking for an associate doctor. And I teach how to, I go over all this. I teach how to look at what to look for. You just haven't heard, you just haven't gotten that material yet. But we teach who to pick, how to pick, how to train, all that stuff. And I essentially train your associate doctor anyway. So, and then boom, off to the races. Hey, by the way, Seamus, how much easier... You saw where I helped you hire your associate doctor, right, Seamus?
Yeah.
How to pick them, what to look for, all that stuff, right?
Oh, you did a perfect job. I mean, it was incredible. You got the perfect guy for us.
And then, well, you did you used the material to filter it down, and then I went in and helped interview and nail it down.
Yep.
And same with the training. You used my tapes and seminars and webinars for the training, right?
Yep.
Okay. So I carried a pretty decent amount of the weight to make all this happen, right?
Right.
But my point is, how much easier is it now for you, after you've gone through the first one and now they're productive, how much easier is it going to be for you to do the second one?
It's going to be a breeze. You know,
You're absolutely right. I mean, the learning curve is unbelievable with the first associate doctor. And most people that never learned how to do an associate doctor, you know, usually it doesn't work out because they don't know how to pick them, they don't know how to train them, and they don't have systems. So they usually associate doctors don't work out at all. But when you know how to pick them and train them and have systems, they almost always work out. They work out good because you only need to see 80 visits a week. An associate doctor seeing 80 visits a week at $50 a visit, and that's if it's split 50-50. And it's not even split 50-50 in the beginning. They get a third, you take two-thirds. And then after their skill level and all that's come up, we'll take them to 50-50 or even higher. But, that second doctor is going to be unbelievably easy because of what you went through the first time. The first associate doctor, but man, getting to that second one is so much easier. That's why I say, what out of 77 offices, which one was the easiest that I've opened? Which one was the easiest to open? Number 77.
The last one.
Yeah. The first one was the most difficult. That was where all the learning curve was at. And, you know, by the time I got to the third office, I was rubber stamping them. I think I opened two, after my offices, I opened two offices individually, like one and then one. No, I did three, one, one, and one. And after I did one, one, and one, three offices, I never did one again. I went to three. Right? Then I trained three people at the same time, and I opened three offices simultaneously. Then I went to five. Then I went to seven. That's what happened. Because you get these systems down. But how well is it going to work, Mark, if you don't even have patient education down 6 months later?
Not very well.
You'll never be able to bring on an associate.
Right.
So why don't we plan on that, guys? I mean, come on, Steve. Let's put some timelines down. Stop letting this stuff drag out. So from the time you, and you should be grading, and I say you should be grading out in an 8 or better with patient retention. Just bring your tapes here and we evaluate them. And then also your statistics, you know, the statistics you want for prepays, patient visit averages, you know, what it is you want, and then work to that skill level. And that's it. That's it. We go to the associate doctor from there. And then, of course, we add in the marketing systems, and wham, you know, it's off to the races. So you guys don't know, Steve knows. Mark, I mean, Seamus increased his business over $1 million in 1 year from the marketing systems. So, I mean, Seamus, can you see how you should have like a McDonald's University? You should just have all your system in place, all your staff in place, and then you should just be hiring and training doctors to just process all the people and all the new patients, and then go to your next office. Then they'll go to your next satellite office, right?
Yeah.
That's just the way it should play out from here. So you start using your mind more than your body. You start becoming more of a manager trainer instead of the widget maker day to day. Remember, Steve, it's the worst kind of money you can make. Being in that office treating patients, it's the lowest level of money you can make. It's exchange of time for money, and it's taxed at the highest rate. It's the worst type of income you can make. But everybody's fixated on it and stays on it. Stop that. So hit the health self-discipline a little bit, put some deadlines to your objectives, like this patient, you know, I want to get to a scale of 1 to 8 out of 10. I want to be an 8 out of 10 as far as being a black belt. I want to do that 90 days, and I'm going to interview associate doctors my fourth month. That's what should happen. And then there you go. Off to the races. Life's pretty fun. Chiropractic's hell of a... I mean, how much fun is chiropractic now, Seamus, after 30 years in practice?
I love it. I have no complaints.
I mean, hell of a lot nicer to love when you're in control of your destiny, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pure... Now it's like a... You just want, it's kind of more like more passionate now about it, you know, because you can see what you can do with your trainings.
Yeah. That's why I say the number one burnout factor is when you're in your office by your own, don't have an associate doctor. That's when it's like running through mud, like dragging your butt through mud. You know, after so many years, it just, it's like, oh man, I got to do this. And you know, you're not anxious to see the patients. You're like, oh, I know what that was like. I've burnt out in 2 years. I worked 6 days a week. I even worked Saturdays. I know what that's like when that door comes open and patient comes in and you're like, oh, I got to get up and see another patient. You know, I'm like, oh, shit. That's called burnout, man. That's not the way to live. But that's what happens when you're in your office by yourself and you can't get away because you don't have associate doctors, because you don't have good systems. It's very easy to not be excited about seeing your patients. There's the marketing seminar is in September. That's going to be in Portland, Oregon. It's actually going to be in Tom Updahl's office. Tom just opened he just had a brand new office built. So he took on his associate doctor, maxed out his office. Then he went and had a brand new office built. So he just moved over there last month. Now he's hiring, he's interviewing and hiring his second associate doctor. And he not only built that piece of real estate that he owns, the real estate that he left, he bought, he's renting that out. And he bought enough land that he's actually building other pieces of real estate on the land where his office is. This is how you do it. This is how you do it. So we're doing the marketing seminar in his new office. And part of the reason for that is to see his office. I wanted to see his office and all, but let everybody else kind of experience that story and see it also. You know, it's kind of motivating. Well, he had none of that 2 years ago. He had a little office by himself. He was burnt out, seeing 120 visits a week, and didn't like chiropractic. That's where he was 2 years ago. Now he's loving life. Works part-time, has one full-time, opened his second office. So he's got three pieces of real estate now. He's got his home, he's got his first office, and he's got that he's renting out. Now he's got in his second office, and he's got enough land on there because I helped him do this. I helped him negotiate the real estate. And then we brought on his associate doctor. We trained his associate doctor. And then so he's making a passive six-figure income from his associate doctor. He's making a passive income from his first piece of real estate. He's got two passive income sources right now. He's working on his third one. He's interviewing his second associate doctor. And he's starting the other pieces of real estate. Tom's loving life right now. So pretty cool stuff. That's the exciting stuff for me is when I see stuff like that. I see Seamus go over $1 million. I see him open a second office successfully, seeing 120 visits a week at 3 days a week. And that's just doing nothing, going to get better. Go to the second associate doctor to the main office. And then I already talked with Seamus about his blueprint. Seamus, remember we said with you, Seamus does 50% personal injury. And I said, all you do is maximize your office first. He's got a main office with him and his brother. I said, at least get 1 to 2 associate doctors in there. I said, that's really what you want to do. And then keep bringing the associate doctors in. But what you do is with all the attorney relationships that you have, and this is exactly what Seamus did, ask them where they have clients. Potential personal injury patients, but they're too far to come to your office. And that's what Seamus did. And they said, oh, we have a lot of patients out in Riverview. So Seamus goes and opens. In other words, when you do it like this, you're guaranteed to have success because you know the business is already there from what you've established. That was part of what made this so successful, combined with picking the associate and training the associate. That's how that happened. This is not an accident, right? This is not random stuff. And so, Seamus, can you see how easy it is going to be to open your second office using the exact same formula or your third office using the exact same formula?
Yeah, that's how you do it.
By the way, have you already talked to the attorneys and said where the next location is?
Not yet. I kind of, with everything that's happening, I haven't been. With the summertime, I haven't really talked to anybody about that. I'm going to start back up again in the fall, meeting up with them and talking to them where should the next office should be at, you know.
Yeah, can you see how that's a guaranteed success?
Yeah.
So you already know you're going to have X amount of business there to start with. Then combine that with a well-trained associate doctor. That's called a great formula. And then just rinse and repeat. And these offices... And this is the only, and I say this, this is the only type of chiropractic office that you can maintain ownership of. When it's personal injury and you are the driver, in other words, Seamus is the rainmaker for these offices, all these connections and all that. That is the only type of office that you can maintain control of and have associate doctors in. And it actually works. Otherwise, there's too small a percentage of people looking for chiropractors and that's why typically doctors who try to have a second, third, or fourth office never work out because nobody wants to make money for somebody else. As soon as somebody knows how to be successful, they don't want to stay in that office for you. They go do it on their own. So if any of these, first of all, we give these guys a good deal, but Seamus is the rainmaker. These guys are not the rainmakers. Seamus is not dependent on that guy to get new patients. If he was, he'd be screwed.
Totally.
And so this is all purposeful. So all Seamus has to do, we just give that guy a good deal. And if he wants to leave, big deal. How easy is it going to be able to replace him if John wants to leave now, Seamus?
Oh, no big deal. Hit the road if you want.
Yeah, it's nothing. Exactly right. So you open the third, third office. You go to the location where you're already generating the business from. You already know the attorney said, I've got the business. And then you hire people, associate doctors, exactly like we teach. You train them like we teach, and wham. You know, it's instant success, instant. And there you go. A lot of fun. A lot of fun.